Ever find yourself scratching your head over the e-commerce acronyms PDM, PLM, and PIM, or PIM, wondering what exactly sets them all apart? You're not alone. With all the P something M systems out there, it's easy to get mixed up. But don't worry, I'm here to answer all your e-commerce doubts, one acronym at a time. Mikey with Politics here, and in this video, we're gonna dive into what each of these systems does, how they differ from one another, and some real-world examples of how using one or more of them can help your business. Let's get started, and don't forget, you can jump ahead to any section you like using the chapter links down below. Let's start with PDM. Product Data Management Software is essentially a central system for organizing and sharing all product design and engineering-related data. The system is designed to handle complex technical information, including CAD files, engineering drawings, material specifications, and more. PDM systems are primarily built to help your technical team, so your engineers, designers, and manufacturing personnel, and let them easily store, retrieve, and manage critical data throughout the product development process. The software also lets them share that technical information with and get input from other departments when necessary, by providing a single source of truth for this area of your product data. This not only improves efficiency, but also reduces errors caused by mismanaged or outdated information being stored in separate data silos. PDM tools can help companies that want to manage their product development cycle more effectively, since they make sure that all the technical aspects of a product are well documented and accessible to anyone who needs them. In particular, companies in industries with complex product designs, like the automotive, aerospace, and electronics sectors, will find PDM systems especially beneficial. For example, an automotive manufacturer can use PDM to manage the thousands of parts and assemblies in a car, tracking all of their revisions and making sure that design changes are accurately reflected in all the relevant documentation. If you'd like to learn more about PDM software, you can check out our other video linked below that gets into it in a bit more depth. Next, we have Product Lifecycle Management, or PLM. This is your overarching system for managing the entire lifecycle of a product, from inception all the way through to retirement. Unlike PDM, which focuses on the technical details of product development, PLM covers a broader range of processes, including idea generation, design and development, manufacturing, marketing, sales, and even disposal or recycling in the end. PLM software integrates data across all these different stages to give a comprehensive overview of a product's journey. This integration helps with coordination and decision-making across different departments, since it helps make sure that everyone involved in a product's lifecycle is working with the same central information. PLM has the goal of helping businesses manage their products in a more holistic way, so thinking about the lifecycle as a whole, which then leads to better strategic planning, cost reduction, and more efficient allocation of resources. It's about keeping the entire product journey in perspective and making informed decisions as a result to increase the product's success and its longevity in the market. A typical use case could be a consumer electronics company working out the details of launching a new smartphone onto the market and using this software to coordinate between the different departments. The engineering team can use PLM software to share their design with supply chain logistics, who can then use that information to figure out the details of sourcing different parts and to plan distribution of the finished phones. The marketing team could use the software too, to stay in the loop about product details and predicted release dates in order to include accurate information in their campaigns. Even after the phone has been released, the customer service team could use PLM to get information about the product and access technical details when helping customers. Finally, Product Information Management, or PIM, is software for handling all the information that's required to market and sell products effectively. This includes detailed product descriptions, pricing information, SEO content, and anything else that might influence a customer's purchasing decision. Unlike PDM and PLM, which are more internally focused, PIM is all about getting the most accurate and appealing product information possible out onto all your various sales channels, as in your e-commerce websites, digital catalogs, retail partners, and more. PIM systems also often come equipped with digital asset management, or DAM capabilities, which allow marketing teams to easily manage and distribute multimedia, so product images, videos, and so on, in the same place as product information. The primary goals of PIM systems like these are to improve product visibility and appeal, make the process of bringing products to market more efficient, and ultimately to drive sales by helping guarantee consistency and accuracy in product information across all customer touch points. A fashion retailer, for example, can use a PIM tool to update and distribute its seasonal catalog efficiently across various different online marketplaces while keeping product descriptions, sizes, colors, and pricing consistent and up to date with minimal effort. We've got loads more resources about PIM. It's kind of our thing. So again, check the description if you want to learn more. Now that we've laid out the basics of PDM, PLM, and PIM, let's dive deeper into their differences, including their different focuses and data types. All of these types of software are designed to help store and share data, but where they differ is in the type of data they specialize in. PDM is all about technical details, especially those related to product design and development. PLM is more general and focuses on coordinating all the different stages of a product's lifecycle. Then we have PIM, which tackles the customer-facing side of your data and makes sure you've got consistent and appealing information on all your different sales channels. Naturally, there's a degree of overlap between these systems, as some product information is going to appear in all three. SKUs, for example, are going to appear everywhere since they're how systems like these identify your products. Some data and files, though, are really best handled by one system in particular. PDM software has specialized features to help with CAD files and bills of materials. PLM software will generally have features to handle these too, but also tools to handle supply chain and distribution data. Then there's PIM software with features that are more helpful for SEO content and marketing materials, like data formatting and image resizing options on export. When choosing between these systems, your first step should be to consider what areas of your business need the most technical assistance. Identify which departments have data bottlenecks that are slowing down your processes, and then find the right software solution to help in that particular area. Of course, you have to bear the relevant costs in mind as well. PLM software, for example, tends to be more expensive than PDM or PIM due to its wider-reaching scope. Okay, so we've seen that each system has its own focus and use case, but the real magic happens when these systems work together. Especially for larger companies, integrating PDM, PLM, and PIM systems into one tech stack can transform product management into a seamless, super efficient operation with everything completely in sync from the earliest stages of product design until the final sale. Let's look at how it could work for a company that has all three systems in place. For this example, let's say a furniture company that wants to put out a new line of office chairs. With this three system setup, both the PDM and PLM systems will be in use from the start. When the engineering team gets started with mock-ups and prototypes, the PDM system can manage the technical specifications and design files for the new line of chairs, making sure their work is accurately documented and easily accessible. At the same time, the PLM system can oversee the chair's entire lifecycle from initial concept through to manufacturing and beyond, to make sure everything is on track and coordinate between design, supply chain, the product team, and marketing to get the product to market at the right time and cost. Finally, the PIM system would come into play as the chairs are getting ready for sale and the team starts adding in product descriptions, pack shots, and, well, all the other information they need to show their new chairs attractively and consistently on their websites. By using PDM for precision in design, PLM for strategic lifecycle management, and PIM for market appeal and consistency, businesses can reach a standard of coordination and efficiency that massively boosts market success, increases customer satisfaction, and generally takes their e-commerce game to the next level. As we wrap things up, remember that the true value of PDM, PLM, and PIM depends on the needs of your particular business, and that in many larger scale cases, their biggest advantage is their ability to work together. Whether you're optimizing product designs, strategizing for future developments, or presenting products to market, these systems are your key to a successful product management strategy. For more insights into how to make your product data management more efficient, be sure to check out our additional resources down in the description. Anyway, thanks for watching. And if you found this video helpful, then remember to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to get more e-commerce content in the future. See you next time.
What is PIM? Baby, don't hurt me. Hurt me. Bruh, bruh.